However, Poonam got us that very interesting update on bank's exposure to JPA. Actually, pull up, we'll get in JPA Associates as well, but let's get in Poonam to tell us which are the banks which, as of FY14, I believe, Poonam, had a sizable exposure to JPA Associates.
That's true, Neeraj. We do have the data as of FY14 as of now, because as of FY14, we had JPA Group as a consolidated level had nearly over 60,000 crore of exposure to the banking system at the consolidated level. And the highest exposure that banks have are ICICI Bank, which had nearly 12,800 crore of exposure, IDBI Bank, SBI, PNB, UCO Bank, Canara Bank, Corporation Bank, Central Bank, United Bank. So all these banks have the highest amount of exposure to the JPA Group. With CARE rating downgrading JPA Group, it does not directly mean that these accounts, that this account turns into an NPA, but it clearly highlights, as we all know, that this account is a very high risk account for the entire system. So we really have to keep a watch on this. As of now, no confirmations that this account turning into NPA for any of the banks, but high exposure, these are the banks that have high exposure. Also, Yes Bank has good amount of exposure to JPA account. As of FY15, we had nearly, Yes Bank would have approximately 2% of exposure of the loans to JPA account as per the latest UPS report. And also, we would have Axis Bank having very less exposure, around 0.5% of FY15 loan, and HDFC Bank as well as Indusind Bank would have negligible or to no exposure to the JPA Group. So these are the major banks which have good amount of exposure, and we do need to keep a watchful eye on these banks.
Okay, Poonam, we're going to leave it at that. In fact, CARE has revised the ratings assigned to the bank facilities and instruments of JPA Associates. So let's bring on board, this of course is the big voice today on the market, Swati Agarwal, Regional Head CARE Ratings. She joins us on the phone line from Delhi. Swati, hi, good morning. Thank you so much for joining us on the show today. Very quickly, yeah, your hi, rating rationale for JPA Associates.
See, JPA Associates, like you've been also been talking about, they've had, they have, if you look at the history, they've gone through a series of expansions and in various sectors, real estate, cement, engineering, roads, etc., and power, of course. So they have, you know, the economic environment as well as some of the delays in their monetization program has led to some kind of cash flow mismatches. And therefore, the revision in the rating is a reflection of that. You know, they have missed certain interest repayments timely, which according to a rating agency should be made timely. And therefore, the rating change reflects that.
So, you know, I just wanted to get a sense of how is this the lowest rating, or I mean, of course, not about default, but beyond that. And what are the implications of this downgrade for the banking system? Because as my analyst was saying, if I add up the numbers, even if they are of FY14, they easily add up to an exposure of over 40,000 crores.
Right, that is true. See, this is a default rating. D rating essentially is obviously the lowest of the band. And like I said, it means that the repayments have not been met on time. So that is where the rating, I mean, just to also clarify to the viewers and everybody, rating agencies work on timely repayments. So if your repayments are not being made on time, then rating agencies have to take the necessary action, and which means a default. So this is a reflection of that. Now, coming to your second question, which is a total overall exposure. Now, 40,000 is 40,000, or I would say, let's say 60,000, I think, is the overall group exposure.
Okay.
Correct. And so this downgrade of D is primarily for Jaiprakash Associates, which could have a 40,000. And like the market, you would be also be aware that they have undertaken certain monetization, asset monetization steps. Yeah. And that is where it is.
Swati, let me just ask this to you point blank. You know, it's one of the groups, frankly, that has actually taken a divestment drive in order to, you know, help deleverage. But maybe this leverage is just so high that it's becoming difficult. In your experience, with such ratings that you would have assigned to companies, does it become increasingly difficult for the companies to meet these obligations? Would they typically result in a default?
So it's also about, like I said, I mean, there are ways, if you look at traditional sectors, there are leverages, right? Power has leverage, steel has leverage, cement has leverage. So it's about how a company manages the cash flow. So now when you company takes various steps to manage its cash flows, and it could mean getting in equity, it could mean getting in QIPs, it could mean monetization of assets. Now, in any case, or let's say we can't highlight any one company, but any company, if there is a mismatch between the cash flows, let's say their steps taken to monetization or steps to bring in additional or let's say prop up the cash flows, if that does not go through the way it was planned or envisaged, then of course the ratings get impacted.
Swati, you must have read JP Associates in great detail and the kind of exposure that banks have to this account. What is your view? Have banks already termed JPA as an NPA, or is it yet to be done?
No, not at all. According to the information that is available to us, we don't think that it is an NPA. They are, yes, going through a stressful period. They are going through liquidity mismatches, and that is where it is. But as far as we don't have like update on information, but according to us, we don't think it is an NPA.
So are you seeing similar stress when it comes to other infrastructure, steel, etc. companies?
Yes, stress has been there. If you look at it, if you track last 1 or 2 years, there have been downgrades happening in these sectors, infrastructure, power, steel. And it is a reflection of the stress, and which is coupled by both the economic environment and the debt-laden expansions. So therefore, which has led to, mismatch between the cash flows which were expected and are getting generated towards the repayment liabilities.
Swati, I mean, is there possibility that JP Associates could default as well?
No, from a rating agency parlance, if you are not making the payment on the due date, it is a default. And that is what we have reflected in the rating. Default as considered by the banking system is slightly different. They look at an NP.
Okay, Swati, we'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining in and giving us this perspective as well. That's JP Associates, I'll be honest enough to admit that, as I said, this is one of the few groups that I've seen which has actually gone out and in a massive way sold their family silver to repay the debt. So the intent is probably there, but just that, the intent will not help. The size of the mismatch is probably just so high that it becomes increasingly difficult for JP Associates to really satisfy the debt obligations that they have. But CARE Ratings has downgraded the ratings to D, which is the default status. Let's see if it actually gets classified as an NPA or no. Too soon to speak about it. They're trying, as we've seen in the various cement asset sales to UltraTech and a few other companies. Let's see if it yields any results. For now, JPA down 4% at the low point of the day. Which brings me to ICICI Bank, actually. That one has a sizable exposure. Nowhere compared to some of the other steel companies and the write-offs that companies have had to take. But 10,000-11,000 crores as of FY14, if I'm not wrong, that's quite large. And that stock is down about 1.5% today, 308. I don't know if it's because of this or some other reasons, but ICICI Bank is feeling a little bit of pressure today. So do watch out for this one. A thought really on ICICI Bank, Mitesh Thakkar, as a trade, 1.5% down. Would you go ahead and initiate any fresh trades on ICICI Bank?
Yes, Neeraj. In fact, that's one of our morning recommendations. I think it's also the 955 recommendation from my side. It's giving a minor breakdown on the charts, slipping below the key averages. I think keeping the stop at about 314, 315, I think, I would be comfortable looking at targets around 295, 290 on the downside. So next couple of days could be negative for the stock price, clearly.
Okay, and IDBI, of course, is the other one. But I think L&T Finance...